In the depths of World War II, a sinister secret unfolded, one that has long been concealed. It is a chilling tale of unimaginable suffering endured by women at the merciless hands of Nazi captors. Renowned writer Daniel Grant and survivor Claudia Vilor embark on a daring journey, peeling back the layers of silence to expose the chilling truth. Brace yourself for a gripping video that unveils the untold horrors, the harrowing punishments inflicted upon these fearless women who stood tall amidst the shadows of war. The Untold Horrors, Women's Plight in World War II, Nazi Captivity. During World War II, Soviet military women suffered unspeakable horrors at the hands of German Nazis. A documentary by writer Daniel Grant and survivor Claudia Viler sheds light on their harrowing experiences. German soldiers showed no mercy, treating women and children no differently than men. Women were viewed as disposable objects of pleasure, enduring brutal treatment and even death. Claudia Viler's account exemplifies the suffering endured by these women. Severely beaten by German officers, her visible injuries were callously disregarded. Despite her wounded legs and excruciating pain, she faced relentless assault. Claudia's sweat-drenched face became a testament to her indescribable agony. Grant and Viler's 1976 publication was a bold step, as discussing such topics was taboo at the time. The memories of surviving women were etched with unimaginable cruelty, rarely broached. Yet, their work exposed the appalling treatment of captured military women by the Germans, highlighting the capture of a brave 35-year-old woman after a grueling battle. While the torment endured by men in Nazi camps has been extensively documented, the experiences of women and girls received little attention. Discussions and writings often overlooked the unpleasant details. However, it is crucial to acknowledge the significant contributions made by female servicemen on the front lines of the Second World War. They served as snipers, nurses, pilots, signalers, and anti-aircraft gunners. Shockingly, the treatment of female servicemen captured by the Germans remains largely unknown. The Forgotten Sacrifice, Tragic Fate of Women in World War II. During World War II, the treatment of women in Germany violated the provisions of the Geneva Convention, despite Germany being a signatory. Female soldiers who courageously served their country on the Eastern Front faced unimaginable fear and sorrow, with only a few managing to escape alive. Their untold stories and immense sacrifices deserve to be acknowledged and remembered. The Third Reich's plan involved the near extermination of female prisoners, as they saw no value in caring for captive women. Female soldiers in military uniforms were considered equivalent to partisans and were promptly executed. This decision was primarily driven by practical reasons. Male prisoners could be exploited for labor, while overworked women succumbed to death quickly. Around 1 million women served in the Soviet Army during World War II, with an impressive 80,000 holding officer ranks. However, the Third Reich refused to recognize them as full-fledged soldiers, categorizing them derogatorily as forest bandits. There were no official orders from the Third Reich leadership on how to handle female servicemen, but a document signed by Field Marshal General Gunther von Kluge revealed his chilling directive to summarily shoot women in military attire. It is likely that similar instructions existed within other units of the Wehrmacht, though the full extent remains unknown. Quantifying the number of Soviet women who perished due to these orders is challenging. In the early years of the war, instances of female soldiers being captured and sent to concentration camps were rare exceptions. Many courageous Soviet women found themselves on the battlefields, becoming targets of merciless Nazi reprisals. They endured torment and abuse before succumbing to death. Testimonies from Soviet Army servicemen recount encounters with lifeless bodies of female comrades near Moscow who had been captured and held prisoner by the Germans, enduring cruelty and degradation. Accounts from German soldiers shed light on the prevailing attitudes within the Nazi ranks. They recount encounters with female prisoners, including a strikingly beautiful woman taken to an operating room before being executed. Disturbing letters from German officers reveal that the presence of a gun to their heads made it easier for them to commit heinous acts. These testimonies offer a glimpse into the dehumanization and brutality inflicted upon captured women. In Svetlana Alexievich's work, The War Has Not a Woman's Face, she conveys the experiences of female officers who witnessed unimaginable atrocities. One officer recalls the haunting image of a young nurse, tortured and ravaged by the Nazis, with prematurely gray hair. It becomes clear that death on the battlefield was not the worst fate for female servicemen from the USSR. The horrors multiplied for those confined within concentration camps. The plight of these women, their sacrifices, and the unspeakable cruelty they endured during wartime remain a tragic chapter in history. Their stories, often overshadowed by more widely known accounts of male suffering, deserve to be heard and acknowledged. The courage and suffering of Soviet women in World War II. A chilling account of a major in the Soviet Army stands as a testament to the unspeakable suffering endured by these brave women. In 1944, she was transported to the Stutthof concentration camp, where she became a constant target of abuse and degradation. Her harrowing experience represents the anguish faced by numerous female prisoners. The stories and testimonies of these women shed light on the grim reality they faced. Their sacrifices and resilience deserve remembrance and recognition, as they exhibited unwavering courage in the face of atrocities. In the Stutthof camp, this major faced relentless abuse and degradation. She was forced to strip while sadistic captors took cruel photographs, reveling in her vulnerability. In a courageous act of defiance, she spat in the face of one tormentor, triggering a brutal retaliation that led to her being callously shoved into a scorching crematorium oven. Such massacres were tragically common in the concentration camps, yet there were moments when the fearlessness of Soviet women temporarily halted their persecution, astonishing even the SS officers. In Ravensbrück concentration camp in 1943, captured nurses, doctors, and medical personnel staged a remarkable display of defiance. Refusing to sew uniforms for the Nazis, they cited the prohibition of forced labor for military personnel under the Geneva Convention. In response, hunger and bitter cold became their constant companions as they were forced to march without adequate clothing. Undeterred, these resilient women raised their voices in song, their defiant chorus echoing through the camp. Witnessing their solidarity, the commandant intervened, ending their punishment and assigning them alternative tasks. Ravensbrück bore witness to the suffering of over 130,000 women during the war, with approximately 92,000 losing their lives to exhaustion, disease, and persecution. Among the victims were Soviet servicewomen, including nurses and signalers who had valiantly fought in Crimea. Singled out and confined to a separate unit within Ravensbrück, they endured even harsher conditions. While Ravensbrück may have been relatively less dire compared to other camps, it offered no respite for these female servicewomen who endured humiliation and often met untimely deaths. Unforgettable stories, women's struggles in concentration camps. The experiences of brave women in concentration camps reveal the pervasive cruelty and dehumanization they endured. Their unwavering strength and resilience in the face of unimaginable horrors serve as a solemn reminder of the atrocities committed. These stories must be heard, honoring their sacrifices and preventing such inhumanity from being forgotten. The women suffered hunger, grueling labor, and chilling conditions in addition to the torment inflicted by SS guards. Towards the end of the war, a decree was issued for the treatment of female prisoners of war, but it came too late for many who had already perished. In captivity, the author recounts how women entering camps underwent gynecological examinations. Most Soviet captives were found to be virgins, which intensified their mistreatment and vulnerability. Over 1 million Soviet women in the war faced immense hardships if captured, envying their fallen comrades who died on the battlefield. Unfortunately, statistics on tortured and executed female prisoners of war are not available, highlighting the distressing reality of injustice. While the perpetrators cannot be held accountable, preserving these stories is crucial.